This video is about internal resistance. Internal resistance refers to the resistance inside of a battery. No battery is ideal and all contain at least a little resistance inside of them. In IB, we use this symbol to show internal resistance. So we've got this battery, this dotted line represents the kind of barrier of the battery. Anything inside of that dotted line is inside of the battery, which we symbolize with those cell symbols, and it also contains an internal resistance, which we symbolize just like any other resistor with that resistor symbol with the lowercase r. We call the voltage that the battery delivers to the rest of the circuit the terminal voltage. So we'll talk about that more in just a moment. And the variable for internal resistance is lowercase r. So before this, we were using capital R for resistances. For internal resistance specifically, we use lowercase r. In all previous problems, the voltage we've been talking about has really been the terminal voltage of the battery, just the voltage that the battery gives to the rest of the circuit, excluding the voltage drop that occurs within the battery itself. Here's an example problem with internal resistance. What is the terminal voltage of this battery? So we can see that this battery contains this voltage of 10, and the internal resistance is 2 ohms, and it also has a 5 and 3 ohm resistor outside of the battery. So I can see that the equivalent resistance in the circuit is going to be equal to 10 ohms because the internal resistance behaves like any other resistor in the circuit. It just happens to be inside the battery. So it's also in series with those two other resistors. So those add together to make 10 ohms. Using V equals IR, I can see that the current in the circuit is 1 amp. So if this current is 1 amp, each of these resistors is experiencing 1 amp of current. And I can use that to calculate the voltage drop in each resistor. So in the 3 ohm resistor, there's a voltage drop of 3, and in the 5 ohm resistor, there's a voltage drop of 5, using V equals IR. And inside of the battery, there's a voltage drop of 2. So what that means is that if we just pay attention to what's happening outside of the battery is delivering 8 volts to the outside of the circuit. So we would say that the terminal voltage of this battery is 8 volts. From one terminal of the battery to the other, it delivers 8 volts. There's an 8 volt drop in electrical potential. In internal resistance problems, we refer to the voltage source inside the battery as the electromotive force, or EMF. This can be confusing because EMF is actually not a force, it's a voltage causing electrons to move. It's measured in volts and can be used as the voltage in the circuit when you are considering the internal resistance. So when we say EMF, we mean that full total voltage inside of the battery, whereas when we just use the word voltage, we're usually really referring to the terminal voltage, so there's a difference here. EMF refers to the total voltage experienced by everything in the circuit, including the internal resistance. Whereas voltage is referring to the terminal voltage, just the voltage drop that's delivered outside of the battery. The IB symbol for EMF is epsilon, that's a lowercase epsilon specifically, it's a Greek letter. So we would say in this problem here that the EMF epsilon is equal to 10 volts, but the voltage, or the terminal voltage, is equal to 8 volts. So that's the difference between these two things. So going back to this problem here, I know that the current flowing through this is 1 amp, so that means that the voltage drop inside of this battery is 2 volts. So I can see here that the EMF is going to be equal to that voltage drop inside of the battery plus the terminal voltage of the battery. So basically, whatever voltage drop happens outside of the battery plus whatever voltage drop happens inside the battery, IR, those two things added together are equal to the EMF of the battery. So in this case, the outer voltage drop is 8 and the inner voltage drop is 2. So altogether, the EMF is clearly 10 volts. If I rearrange this equation and call V the current times the equivalent resistance outside of the battery, I end up with this equation. The EMF is equal to the current multiplied by the sum of the resistance in the circuit plus the internal resistance of the battery. This equation appears in your IB data booklet. So this is the information that you're given in your data booklet about EMF and internal resistance in general. Going back to this first equation, if I rearrange this equation to look like this and then create a graph of the voltage in the circuit on the y-axis and the current in the circuit on the x-axis, I can see that this equation fits y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So this is going to yield an important pattern that's going to show up on a few different IB problems, where if you make a graph of the voltage on the y-axis and the current on the x-axis of a circuit with internal resistance, the y-intercept of the graph is going to be the EMF of the battery, and the slope of the graph is going to be the negative internal resistance of the battery. So if you're ever asked the question about which graph shows a greater internal resistance, it's going to be the one with a steeper slope, and the one with a greater EMF is going to be the one with a greater y-intercept. So basically, using a voltage-current graph, you can find the EMF using the y-intercept and the internal resistance using the slope.